Hey, horse people! Buddy had an accident, his leg got cut off. Look at that. Poor horse. Buddy, the post office, P.O. box is getting a little makeover. So he's getting a paint job. One of his legs broke off. I think the damn post office, damn federal employees broke it off, hit it with the damn truck, too lazy to get out and put mail in. So one of his legs is broken. I got to try and fix that. But I wanted to do a, you know, because a lot of times I bitch about things and complain about things. So I got this great little, I decided while I let my paint, my first coat dry, I've been wanting to do this. So I got this great little letter from Sarah in Germany. Look at the little pictures of her cute little horsies. She's pregnant, or she was pregnant. Maybe by now she probably already had the baby. So anyway, congratulations on the baby. And she said her husband likes me too. Probably because he knows I'm giving her good advice. So anyway, she sent me this great letter, and I can't read it all because it's like 3 pages. She took all this time to write me and send me this great care package all the way from Germany. Spent your money. Don't be spending your money on me. You got a kid. You got horses. I appreciate it, but man, I know how hard it is to have extra money laying around. So although I appreciate the chocolate, and I ate it all, and it was really stinking good. But she wrote me this great letter about she was in a barn, and it was full of barn witches, and these crazy women used to run out, and all they knew was the, and I'm paraphrasing this, not her words, you know, to get a horse out in the arena and run it around like crazy and tell everybody how dangerous they were. And I think she said it was a stallion that got put down, or another horse that they just made a stallion. I don't remember exact detail, but they ended up putting a horse down that she knew wasn't bad or mean, and it just tore up. She ended up getting out of the barn like so many women I know do. I mean, people are like, how can you talk so bad about women and have women follow you? I think 80% of my viewers are women, because the women that follow me have common sense and they figure it out. What's this thing blinking for? I saw something blinking over here. Sorry. So, because the women that follow me have common sense and they got a brain and they can think and they know what I'm saying is true. I mean, most of the things I say, women have said and complained to me about. It's not like I'm making it up. I'm sitting around like, let me go see if I can just make something up about a horsewoman that ain't true because, I don't know, hell. I don't like women, so I'll just make stuff up about them. Are you kidding me? So, she sent me this great letter, and she listened to me. She watched my videos. She said it so much helped her horse. She gave me a bunch of credit, although I'm just the messenger for the horse. I mean, I just happen to have a lot of viewers that have made me, I don't know about popular, but have made me significant in their horse area. And they've listened, and the advice, and you know what, my advice isn't perfect, and I'm not the only guy in the world that is saying this. I tell you, everybody that's successful with horses, the key is successful, they understand the horse and the way it thinks about pressure and release and their prey, predator, and their vision, and how they sense things, and how to read them, and how everything they do is a reflection, action against us, and our action causes their reaction, and we should be looking for responses and not react. I'm saying the same thing that every successful horse person knows and understands, if they're successful with horses. There's nobody out there with the super special secret, my way or the highway, and this way, and my special rope, and my special bit, and my special this, and my special that. It's all BS, people. And again, I didn't invent this. I didn't do it. Sometimes I'm a pretty good teacher. And I've been told this throughout my life that I'm a good instructor because I'm passionate, and I usually try to become expertise in my area that I'm teaching so I have credibility and people see that I can do it. I'm not just talking it. I can actually do it. So that's why I'm able to pass this message on. So you know what? And some people, I don't care who they are, they just don't like my style. And that's okay. Even when I was training cops and training other people and dogs or whatever, wherever I was at, if I was in a training position and I was an instructor, there were always those people that's like, you know what, I just don't like it. You're loud, you're cocky, you're arrogant, you're in your face, you're not nice, you're not sensitive. Whatever the reason, They just don't like me. That's okay. I don't like them most of the time anyway either. So, look, this letter and this little email.
I love that picture of that little horse. Look how cute he is. Buddy would like have a field day with him. Like, yeehaw, I got a partner, Dad.
So, thank you, Sarah, for the goodies. The bag, it wasn't necessary. You sent it all the way from Germany. I've sent things to Germany. It's freaking expensive. So, although I appreciate this effort, really, if you're far away and you want to help me, go donate. Hey, not money. Don't give money to these damn charities because it just goes in the neurotic owner's pocket. It never goes to the horses. Only give things for the horse. That damn horse charity up there that I gave that saddle to, I bought all these blocks. I bought a feeder. I bought all this stuff I was going to give them. Never call back. They don't want things. They want money. So, I mean, I'm just so tired of charities. But if you give alfalfa hay or good hay that is good, they will feed it to the horse and you know the horse is getting good hay. And, I mean, I've even been to where I can call a feed store in the area of a charity and I will have them deliver the hay so I know it gets there because I'm not close enough. So, if you want to send me cookies or something, especially if you're far away, I appreciate it. It's very nice of you. I mean, watching my videos, clicking like and all that, it gives me money from the advertisement. So I'm perfectly happy with that. I don't want to be out here begging Patron, send me this, send me that. Look, those cookies and that chocolate that you sent was stinking great. It wasn't cookies because someone else tried to send me cookies and I told her I can't take unpackaged food. All these were sealed in plastic bags, so I knew they were safe, so I ate them. But if you send me something that you made, I'm sorry, there's too many wackos out there. I can't touch it. I don't give it to my animals, and I just don't do that. But I wanted to say thank you. Thanks to everybody. I mean, I don't thank the people that really like me, because to me, my thanks is when I see a comment or I get a letter like this that, hey, you've changed the way I treat my horse, and my horse has a better life. I'm safer. I'm more confident. My horse is safer. It's just a happy environment. That's really the best thanks I can get. Well, although I appreciate the chocolate, as you can tell. So, hey, Sarah, thanks for all the stuff that you sent me, and thanks for the great letter, and I'm so glad that Buddy and Mr. T's teaching is actually helping a bunch of horsies. This poor Buddy's leg. The vet's on his way out to sew that back on. He'll be all right. It's just a flesh wound. All right, we'll end that there.